Hello Internet, welcome to the Gaming Article.
Chris, we know game theory is awesome, but please stop trying to be them.
Yes Shades, you're right, let's move on. So earlier this year, we finally got the confirmation that we are indeed getting new Pokemon games, this time in the form of Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. And while many people expected that Pokemon Z was going to be the next game, as always Game Freak did the opposite and announced these games instead. I know here on this channel I've barely touched on Pokemon Sun and Moon, and while I am willing to admit it was because of time constraints, it was also because I wanted to have a good amount of details to go over for not only the return of this show, but also Pokemon Sun and Moon in general. However, I would like to make a disclaimer. The Gaming Article is not a gaming news show. This show is aimed at talking about recent announcements that I am personally interested in. So if you're thinking this is just another news show, then it's not. This show is purely for gaming content, mostly new announcements that I'm interested in covering. So for this episode, I decided I wanted to go over all the newly revealed Pokemon for the fresh Generation 7 and give my thoughts and opinions on each one individually. We have quite a few to go around, so let's start with one of the best things to talk about with every generation, the starters. Now to be honest, I'm going to have to say that out of all the recent starter lineups, I feel that these three are quite solid, as I actually do like all three of them. Past generations have usually left me with at least one I disliked. All three here are good in my opinion. Let's start with Popplio. This one seems to be the more controversial one, as I've seen some people love this Pokemon, while others seem to either dislike it or flat out hate it. For me, it is my least favourite of the three, but I still think it looks good. However, what makes me very interested in this one is the fact that it's classed as the Sea Lion Pokemon. And to me, that gives this guy a lot of potential. As for how it looks right now, it sure is cute and I love the shape for its body, so I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how this one goes. Rowlet is such a huge pull-in for me because I absolutely love owls. They are easily my favourite type of bird and it looks super adorable. Plus it has a bow tie. Okay, yeah, I know it's not actually a bow tie, but since I really like bow ties by default, this is icing on the cake for me. As for Litten, well, if you know me, then you'll know that I am a huge cat lover, as I live with five of them. So I can say I absolutely love Litten's design. I actually am hoping that this Pokemon's final form is going to be a sort of tiger. The patterns of red on its body I think are very well placed, and those beautiful yellow eyes just complement the overall design. As for who my favourite of the one is, it's a very close call between Rowlet and Litten, but if I really had to choose which one I like the most, it's going to have to be Rowlet. But of course, as time moves on, this could change when they finally show us the evolutions. Now for Rockruff. This Pokemon to me is all white, and it certainly has that cute factor. Though I will give credit to its colour, if you can call it that. Given the fact that it's the puppy Pokemon, I think it's safe to say this will be another Pokemon that evolves into a dog, and since dogs are awesome, I have no problem if this is what they're going with. Also, that tail looks super fluffy, I wonder if you can fall asleep in that? Well, perhaps Kamala can, since apparently this Pokemon is always fast asleep. I'm not kidding, its description literally says that nobody has ever seen Kamala awake, and its actual classification is the half-asleep Pokemon. It is also said that this Pokemon has a new ability called Comatose, which only makes it so it can have the sleep status. In other words, it cannot be poisoned, paralyzed, and so on, which may give this Pokemon, or its potential evolution, a place in the metagame. As for its design, I actually really like this one. It's blue, which is awesome, and its general design looks really well put together. And of course, like many Pokemon, it has that cuteness factor. Man, Game Freak really does like to make their Pokemon cute, huh? Up next is Pikipek, which is our generic normal flying type. I am going to be honest here, I really do like the design for this one. Sure, I have often liked the design for Plast flying types, but this one is extra appealing to me. The flow of red on its head really does look good, and of course it's going to be a long beak to make its name stand out better. Aside from that though, the rest is pretty standard, though since this is our general normal flying, I think we can expect this one to get at least one more evolution beyond this one. And if that evolution is anything like this one, I think we can expect something good. And now we have what apparently people are calling the Donald Trump Pokemon Yungoose, which will be serving as our generic normal type. Honestly, I can see the connection to Mr. Trump, but at the same time, I really don't think it when I saw Yungoose. As for the design itself, it's alright. Since I've never really been too much into the generic normal types of the Pokemon games, I can't say I expected much here. All I will say about Yungoose is I think it looks fine. At least it looks better than Bidoof and Patrat. Now for Grubbin, which I'm going to be honest here looks awful. It has very little interesting about it, and clearly this is only there to make way for its evolutions. And speaking of its next evolution, all aboard the Hype Bus! Yeah, this thing literally evolves into a bus bug named Charger Bug. I originally hated this Pokemon, but after looking at how ridiculous it looks, I just cannot bring myself to hate it. Does it look horrible? In my opinion, yes, but it's a funny type of horrible. But now let's move on to what I really think matters, which is Vigavolt, and that makes all the previous forms worth it. Vigavolt is easily one of my favourites in Generation 7. It's got jaws that are menacing, and apparently has the ability to fire electric beams from its mouth. This Pokemon is awesome. Provided its base stats and move pools are good, this definitely is a Pokemon I'm going to use on Pokemon Battle Zone. It really does make me happy knowing that Game Freak still have what it takes to pull out amazing designs like this one. I just cannot imagine how awesome the next Pokemon is. Oh my goodness, Game Freak. What were you smoking when you came up with this? Grubbin and Charizard Bug, you're off the hook. This thing takes the cake when it comes to my least favourite Pokemon of Gen 7. I can't even begin to describe how much I hate Drampa's design. Everything from the shape of the body, the weird hairstyle, its derpy face, not one inch of this Pokemon looks good to me. I mean, what's with those arms? Are they even arms or are they wings? Judging from the fact that many Dragon Pokemon have wings, I'm going to say these are wings, but why? Why is this a thing? Obviously I respect people's opinions if they like Drampa, but I just cannot stomach this thing. Can we please move on? Say hello to Bruxish, and at first I thought this Pokemon looked horrendous, and I will admit I'm still not ecstatic about this Pokemon, it has grown on me a bit. It's a water psychic type that has the ability that blocks all priority moves. Assuming this Pokemon has decent stats and move pool, this Pokemon may have something to offer in competitive play. But its design I cannot say I like very much. Sure, its overall body structure looks alright, but the colour variations and those teeth just put me off it overall. I agree it's not horrible like Drampa, but it's just not my taste. Now for Cutiefly, which I find to be, well, cute. The main thing about this Pokemon I find funny is it has Fly in its name and it's not a flying type. That's not to say it devalues it though, I actually like the design for this one. Its classification is the Bee Fly Pokemon, and I'd say it pulls it off well. I especially like the shading of yellow around its head, similar to Pikipek, I have high hopes for its potential evolution. Now for the Pikachu of this generation, Togedemaru, or Togedemaru? Hope I'm saying that right. I know you're probably getting tired of me saying this, but for this one it has to be said. This Pokemon is so cute. For starters, it's a hedgehog, and an electric one at that. How is this thing not awesome? The patterns on its side are excellent, and the fact that it can roll up and push its spikes out is awesome. Like with owls and cats, I absolutely love hedgehogs. They're super cute, super adorable, and I love them just how much I love this Pokemon. Oh, and it gets Lightning Rod. Neat. Up next I want to go over is Magianna, and I'm sorry to have to say this, but I really don't like this Pokemon's design. It just feels very slapped together with those robotic arms, the cling-clang type of head, and those stupid bunny ears, and a bot on the size of Camilla's breasts, but not in a sexy way. Yeah, I know, this Pokemon has a connection to Volcanion, but that doesn't make me like it. Sorry Magianna fans, I ain't a fan of this one. Now we are coming into the bigger shots of this list, starting with Tapu Koko, I really do love this Pokemon's design. It's an electric fairy type that apparently is the guardian of Mele Mele Island, making it a big deal for the Alola region. For its design, at first I thought it looked weird, but the more I saw of it, the more I found myself loving its design. The arms are weirdly shaped and kinda looks like he's constantly holding two shields, but actually manages to look good, and I especially love the hairstyle it's got going. I also speculate that since Tapu Koko is the guardian of this island, it's safe to say that each island is getting its own legendary guardian. Oh, and look at that! Tapu Koko is part electric, has an ability that is akin to electric terrain, and there is four islands. I'm sure you can see where I'm going with this. Overall, I really like this Pokemon. I think it looks very awesome, and I'm looking forward to seeing how it fares in the long run. And now we reach the climax of this rather long list, Solgaleo and Lunala, who are the legendary representatives of these two games. Lunala is a bat-like psychic ghost Pokemon whose design embodies the moon, while Solgaleo is a psychic steel type whose design embodies the sun. Both of these Pokemon look amazing, and in addition to that, it seems these Pokemon have a form of evolution. While we don't know exactly what they are or exactly how this works, it's been implied that when these two Pokemon use a certain type of move, it activates a type of phase. Solgaleo gets a phase called Radiant Sun, while Lunala gets a phase called Full Moon. It's unclear if this is a sort of Mega Evolution or form change, but it is something I'm looking forward to learning more of.
Man, I really wish they called the phase for Solgaleo Radiant Dawn, because then we could have correctly nicknamed it Ike.
Also, I would like to take this time to link you to a video by Noggin, which explains why Solgaleo is Psychic Steel and does not embody the Fire typing. His video is extremely well detailed, so if you're wondering why this is the case, I highly recommend checking his video out. Link to his video is in the description as well as via an annotation at the end. However, our coverage is almost over, but it has also been reported that Pokken Tournament will soon have an announcement for a new playable Pokemon. This announcement will be made on July 14th. If you want to leave your predictions or who you want in the comments, please feel free to do so. As for who I wanted to be, I'm going to give my vote to Scizor, as out of the three that were recently surfaced through data mining, I think this one has the best shot. Starting from this video onwards, I will be using the gaming article for all news that is related to Pokemon Sun and Moon, so please look forward to those if you are planning to stick around on this channel. Thanks for watching everyone, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!